Greetings. My name is Dr. Zebulon Miletsky, and it is a pleasure to be here with you today for Bellport Middle School's Black History Month celebration. I was with you last year for your celebration, and so much has changed since then, as we all know, and has forced us to find new ways to communicate. So I want to thank Dr. Jamal Colson for inviting me back. And I am enthusiastic in celebrating your wonderful theme this year of Because of Them, We Can. And it inspired me to think about ways that I have been inspired and helped because of them, we can. And it's so important right now because we need each other more than ever. For this Black History Month presentation, I wanted to share with you some of the things that have taken place since I was last with you. And also just to reflect in my own life on how I have been able to learn, study, and be able to teach African-American history at Stony Brook University, where I am an associate professor of Africana studies. And so today it's my distinct pleasure to share a little of that with you. Because of them, we can. Because of them, we can. And as you think about this theme and think about this in your own life, reflect on the people who helped you to get to where you are. And for me, that was my parents. And I wanted to show this because I've been asked to speak about things like this. But this was a chance to reflect on who helps us to get to where we are in life. It is our parents, it's our families. I think about my grandmother, Winifred Deer, pictured here, who passed on several years back, but was a constant source of strength and help in my life. Since the last time I was with you, so much has changed. 2020 changed us, and it will be forever etched in the history of this country, and therefore in the ways that it affected the African-American community, etched in Black history. And so it made me think about ways that we can improve, ways that we can change. This period, if nothing else, has helped many of us reflect on what's important. I think of my grandfather, who was stationed in Tuskegee, Alabama, working alongside the Tuskegee Airmen. I think of his daughter, my mother, and all the amazing things that have taken place over the years. Because of them, we can. It's featured in an article in Newsday. It came out shortly after, or around the same time, I was last speaking at Bellport. And so it means a lot to me, and I'd encourage people to check that out. Because of them, we can come a long way. Dug up some of the old pictures. And I just think about all the mentors and the teachers and the people who helped along the way to get here. That's a big part of African-American culture, and it's a big part of our history. I was given an award by the NAACP of Long Island, Brookhaven. This was all before, right before COVID. I was just so proud to have a chance to be around people who are history makers, the NAACP. Never could have made it. Never could have made it without you, without your help. Think about my family, think about my parents. It's been a long road. I'm thankful for the opportunity to teach, thankful to have a place, to be able to share, and to be able to have amazing students, Stony Brook University. Got a chance to meet Spike Lee. What else can you ask for? And it's all because of community, a lot of folks who come together to make it work. Family. Family is everything. Family is so important. And no matter who your family is, where you come from, treasure that. There's much more about us that's similar than different. And so this has been an honor and a chance to share a little bit about my life with you and a little bit about what it means to me. There's no difference between the person you see in this picture and the person who's speaking to you right now. I am the same. And you'll find that as you grow older, as long as you stay in touch and stay focused on what you love to do, you've come a long way, and really never could have made it without you. And for you, that may be a grandmother, grandfather, mother or father. This is my grandfather and my mother, picture from many years ago. And my family today. This is my wife and my son. And I have another son who was in one of the earlier pictures. And so one other thing I wanted to just leave you with and share with you is you never know where life may be taking you. I had a chance to meet a gentleman who, when I met him, he was a principal of a school in the Bronx. His name is Jamal Bowman, and he is now a congressman representing the 16th congressional district since just this term.
One way we use hip hop. There's a song by Nas called I Can. And the last verse, he says, you know, before we came to this country, we were kings and queens, never porch monkeys. There were empires in Africa called Kush, Timbuktu, where every race came to get books to learn from black teachers who taught Greeks and Romans, Asians, Arabs, and gave them gold. When gold was converted to money, it all changed. Money then became empowerment for Europeans. The Persian military invaded, they learned about the goal, the teachings, and everything sacred, and it goes on and on. So our kids, they know that's our theme song. They memorize that verse. That verse alone gives them a knowledge that has been excluded from American textbooks, right? So American textbooks teach us that black history is all about how your people were colonized by Europeans and enslaved. And from that, you became what you are now, which is a low on the social class, right? Low on the caste system. But our students, we aim to teach them, okay, before you were slaves, what were you and what were your people doing and what was your language and what was your history and what was your culture, right? And learn about, yeah, some Africans actually traded you into slaves and some of your ancestors were kidnapped. So they need to know the entire story. So that right there, talk about emotional intelligence, is also spiritual intelligence. Like, damn, I come from greatness, right? So that's the energy and that's the approach that I take as a teacher and as a principal.
Thank you again for this opportunity to speak to you, to have a chance to check in with my Bellport Middle School community. I value our connection, and I will never forget the beautiful Black History Month ceremony last year, the music, and the school and all that you do. And I thank you so much for your friendship and support. And I will be looking forward to continuing to work with you in the time to come. Until then, stay safe, stay strong, and remember, because of them, we can.
Thank you for joining us this evening. I hope that you are encouraged as much as we are. Again, because of them, we can, this year's theme. We are so thankful for all the participation. And most importantly, we also want to acknowledge and thank our Board of Education that supports us, Superintendent of School, Dr. Gianni and the Cabinet, Bellport Middle School Administration, teachers and faculty, students, parents, and most importantly, each and every one of you that took the time to view our program and our presentation and join us. We hope that this would not be the only event that you celebrate during Black History Month, but this would be one of many. We again just want to say thank you. We want everyone to be safe, stay hopeful, stay healthy, and we look forward to seeing everyone next year back in the building celebrating Black History Month together. Until then, we say thank you and enjoy the rest of your evening.
Just like the river I've been running, every sense. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. It's been too hard living, but I'm afraid to die. 'Cause I don't know what's up there beyond the sky. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Somebody keep telling me don't hang around. It's been a long time coming, but I